everybody, it's Laz again. I forgot about you, even though I'm in beautiful France, Lanescat to be exact. I'm in the countryside of France. Very beautiful, very relaxing. But I'm still doing what I gotta do. I gotta let you guys know what's going on with the CCNA and different types of labs that I wanna show you, especially this one. All right. We always do the router on a stick with a layer 2 switch, right? Because the layer 2 switch, you can't put an IP address on it. As far as for gateways and things like that, you can put the gateway, which is the router, but that's pretty much it. There's no routing involved in the layer 2 switch. You need a layer 3 device, such as the router, where we just trunk the ports on the switch, and then we actually put the right type of encapsulation on the sub-interfaces on the router for each sub-interface. So we would do interface F0/24.10, and it would do incap, which is the encapsulation, .1Q10 to match the VLAN ID, must match the VLAN ID, and then we put the IP address, which is the gateway, right, to our network. So that's how we would normally do it. That's how you will be doing it in the exam. But if you use the layer 3 switch, that takes that out of the equation, and I'm going to show you how that is done. Okay. Now, if you look at the lab that's in front of you, on one side, the right side, you see a layer 3 switch. On the left side, you see a layer 2 switch. Now, you have arrows pointing straight to it. All right. So it's no big deal. You have VLAN 10 and VLAN 20 on both sides. They're both plugged into the same port. So I'm going to be assigning the VLANs to their particular ports. And I will be giving their VLANs an IP address, but I'm also going to be enabling routing. Okay, so since I'm enabling routing, then they'll already be able to talk to each other. The point is, what happens with the router? But we will see. You'll see the difference between using a layer 2 switch and a layer 3 switch when doing multiple VLANs, all right, and then trying to get to the outside. What is it you need to do? So that means, it's lab time. Enough talk. Let's get it done. See you then. All right, everybody. Here we are in the lab. All right, before we start destroying it, all right, because I created it first to make sure everything is working. But so now I'm going to show you, and then we're going to destroy everything, and then we're going to recreate it. Now, obviously, the PCs, if we look at that, there's 10.1. We're using a setter 24, 2D4. You know, that's the gateway I always use. First available for the host, last available for the gateway. We go in here. Oh, not that. There we go. 20.1, 20.254. Awesome. Come in here. We just always want to make sure we want to see what we're working with. 10.1, 10.254. Exactly the same thing. No different. Okay. 10.1, 10.254. I just want to show you the differences. All right. Now I'm going to show you the differences and then we're going to do it. 20.1, 20.254. So here in the layer 2 switch, we enable and do a show VLAN brief. We see that we have two active VLANs. We have VLAN 10, VLAN 20, finance and payroll, and they're assigned to ports 10 and 20. Trying to make it easy, all right? Then if we just do a show start, oh, let me do a show in trunk first. And then we do a show in trunk. Obviously, we're trunking gig 02. This is the port that's going towards the router. All right, so we're going to be using this type of encapsulation, which is 802.1Q. On a layer 2 switch, you don't need to say, hey, we're using 802, you know, not ISL. You don't need to do that. Just do, you know, switch port mode trunk. You're good to go. On the layer 3, you got to actually tell it, hey, we're using this type of encapsulation, then trunk it. Okay? It just won't let you do it right off the bat. All right, and then we're going to do a show start. Take a look at it. All right, no big deal. You can see there that we have switch port access VLAN 10, switch port mode access. All right. And then switch port access VLAN 10, switch port mode access. Awesome. On 10 and 20. And this is our trunk port. We have it right there. That's it. We don't got nothing else on that one. Let's minimize that. Okay. Now we're going to go to our router. All right. This is where the router on a stick. For your certification, for your CCNA, this is exactly, well, I'm not going to say exactly, but When you do a router on a stick, I'll say it that way. When you do a router on a stick, this is how you do it, okay? For certification purposes, this is how you do it. I mean, it's not a secret, okay? This is how you do it. Enable, show start. Let's do a show start. Now you can look at the whole thing. We have, here we go. We have our, we turn on our physical interface. We don't put an IP address on it. We just turn it on. You don't turn it on, you're not going anywhere. All right, so then we have F0.10. All right, this is a visualization purpose. This is a requirement. All right, it must match the VLAN ID, and then I got my gateway address. All right, and the same thing goes for 20. Awesome. All right, and then that's it. No biggie. Let's go ahead and see if we do have connectivity across. You know I do because I checked it already. Oh, I know I do. Up arrow. And then, boom, we have connectivity. Awesome. Lovely. But let's take a look at the Layer 3 switch. Let's take a look at the Layer 3 switch. All right, so I'm going to enable to show VLAN brief. All right, everything seems the same. We have VLAN 10, VLAN 20. There they are. They're assigned to it. Okay. No big deal. Let's do a show start. Ooh, our first change. We have IP routing. It's a Layer 3 switch. It has that capability. That's just why you do it. Okay. Then I'm entering as I go down. Da, 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 da. There's my port, F0.10 port. All right. I'm assigning VLAN 10 to that port. I'm emphasizing port if you didn't get it. All right. All right. I didn't type switch port non-negotiate. I didn't type that. All right. Switch port mode access. Switch port access VLAN 10. I must have used this for another lab or something. Okay. And then port 20. Switch port access VLAN 20. Switch port mode access. There you go. Here's the difference, boys and girls. All right. Well, it was one of the differences. I put an IP address, which is the gateway for VLAN 10 and VLAN 20, or an IP address, right, for VLAN 10 and VLAN 20. 10.254. 20.254. Okay, so the switch in itself becomes the gateway for these devices, these PCs that I have attached to it. That's their gateway. Okay, all right. And then I have a VLAN 1, and all I did, that's just the, I put an IP address on VLAN 1. All the other ports are on VLAN 1. So whatever port is plugged into the router, it's going to be on that network. Okay, and then all I did was say, hey, router rip. I'm attached to these networks. No auto summary. Boom. Done. Okay. And then, of course, we'll do a control C. Show IP route. There you see. We have a routing table. How about that? All right. We don't have that over there. Okay. Boom. There we go. So it seems like they're connected. Let's take a look at the router. What did I do here? Enable. Show start. There's my F00. I don't have sub interfaces. Hello, no sub interfaces. 1.2. Why 1.2? Because VLAN 1 is 1.1. Okay, so I put a point-to-point connection. Okay, let me go back to the topology. All right, point-to-point connection is 1.2. This is 1.1. Okay, this is why I did that. So let's go back over here, and then the router is only connected to 1.1, the 1.0 network. It's not connected to any other network, right? It's the switch that's connected to 1 and 10 and 20 that it needs to advertise, okay? So now we go show IP route. And now we're learning. We're learning about the 10 and the 20 through the routing protocol. So we're routing. We're essentially doing inter-VLAN routing, but we're doing it through routing, okay? So now you've seen the difference. I didn't have to create sub interfaces. All right, on the other one I did. I enabled routing on this one. On the other one I didn't. Okay, so, but let's get it done. Let's do it from scratch. So I'm going to erase start on this. All right, and we're going to do it. Do it, do it. All right, remember on your switches, erase start. You want to do also delete. This is case sensitive, VLAN dot. That, all right, reload. Oh, did I reload on the router? Probably not. Did I? There we go. Erase. Complete. Non-error reloaded. Reload. Confirm. If I did, I don't remember. That's how bad the memory is. All right, let's do the same thing here. All right, we're going to do an erase start. And then delete VLAN.dat. And reload, right? Let's do the same thing for, and you see I don't close them, okay? I don't close them at all, right? And let's do a erase start. And reload. What happened there? Erase start. And reload. Got that caret symbol. Okay, I'm gonna say no on this router. Let me take a look and see if there's anything in there. It's decompressing. What's going on? Packet trace is going crazy as usual. So we're gonna do the layer 2 switch first. The layer 2 switch first. Okay, so let's go inside. We got it. Let's name it. All right, we'll give it a host name. Host name. Layer 2. That's not 2. Layer 2 switch. S, that's not an S. S, can't see. There's two S. All right. If I'm in Google configuration, that would have worked. Host name, layer 2 switch. There you go. Looks beautiful now, doesn't it? So let's grab VLANs. VLAN 10, finance. Let's call it something else. I'm so tired of using the same things. Whatever. Accounting. And then, oh, I'm sorry. Name accounting. All right, and then we have VLAN 20, name, sales, whatever. All right, let's make sure that that is indeed in the do show VLAN brief. Now, you cannot do the do command in your certification. You can't do that. You can do a question mark, you can tab, all right, but you cannot do the do, all right? So we can see here, 10 and 20. They're there, but they're not assigned to port. So let's assign them to a port. So let's exit. Interface. They're 10 and 20, so let's do those ports. F0/10. Switch port mode access. Switch port access. VLAN 20, 10. Okay? They must be access ports because by default they're auto. So you need to turn them into access ports. All right, so we'll do the same thing for 20, int F0/20, enter, and switch, too much of an abbreviation, switch port mode access, switch port access VLAN 20. All right, going to do a DWR. You need to go to privilege mode and do a copy, run, start. Okay, let's take a look at this. Show VLAN brief. All right, so now we see that 10 and 20 are both on their appropriate ports. All right, cool. We didn't trunk the port though. Which port is actually facing? This is the gig 02 port. Gig 02 port, it's got to be trunked, okay? So we're going to go in here. Do we have any showing trunk? We don't have any ports trunked. So int, global first, int, G0/2 switch port mode trunk. Done, right? So we're done there. And we do a do show in trunk right here. We're not going to see it because the router's interface is down. So now we're going to go to the router's interface. We're going to say, or router, we're going to say no. I don't want the wizard. Enable host name, or config T, I should say. Config T. Host name, R1, creative, R1. All right, we're going to type int F00. I believe that is the interface that I'm using. Yes, I am. Okay, and we cannot put an IP address on the interface because we have two different networks. So we're going to say no shot, but that's it. So I'm going to up arrow, I'm going to do .10 for VLAN 10. I'm going to do end cap, dot 1Q10. This is your requirement. This must match the VLAN ID. All right, and now I'm gonna put the IP address, which is the gateway. IP address, 192.168.10.254.255.255.255.0. Boom. All right, we'll do the same thing for 20. So we're gonna change the 10 to 20 for the interface. Okay, let me get the mouse thing out of the way. Then we'll do the end cap. It's gonna be 20. It's gonna match the VLAN ID. And then the IP address. See, I make it simple. I want you to understand what you're doing. All right, now worry about which IP address was that? Well, 69, 77, 48, 22, you know, doesn't make sense. All right, there we go, that's done. Do WR, Control Z. All right, we'll do a show IP in brief. And we see 224, 224, up, up, everything is up, up. Let's do a show IP route. All right, we see we're connected. All right, so all that's left, really, we see green light, is to test it. Wrong window. There you go. This is from previous, so that doesn't count. All right, so we're going to ping 192.168.10.1. That's the other IP address of the PC on VLAN 10. Obviously, we're in IP version 4, ARP, right? The first one. There you see your replies. Let's get 4 replies just for the heck of it. Boom. We got inter-VLAN connectivity, but you saw how we had to do it. We had to create some interfaces, right? Now we're going to do it on the Layer 3 switch. On the Layer 3 switch. Okay, I'm going to say no. All right, we're going to name it. Config T. All right, so host name, L3SW, Layer 3 switch. All right, and now we're actually going to create the VLAN. So we're going to do VLAN 10, name faculty, how about that? VLAN 20, name students. Awesome. All right, so we have do show VLAN brief. You see the VLANs are there, but they're not assigned to anything. So let's assign them to a port. Same thing we did in the other one. We'll int F0/10. And we'll do switch port mode access, switch port access VLAN 10. Same thing, right? Nothing's changed so far. Did we type IP routing in? I don't remember. F0/20. We'll type it again, no big deal. All right. Switch port mode access. Switch port access VLAN, and then we go 20. Beautiful. All right, Control Z. Tip back to Prismo, get rid of all this gibberish. And do a show VLAN brief. And then your VLANs assigned to the appropriate ports, right? Let's see if we enable routing. Show start. Yeah, I did, IP routing. So IP routing is enabled. So now what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna put the IP addresses on the VLANs, okay? I'll put the IP addresses on the VLANs. All right, so I didn't trunk the port going up. Okay, keep that in mind. Config T, interface, VLAN 10, IP address, 192.168.10.254.255.255.255.255.255.255.255.255.0. Okay, so it's got an IP address there. So int VLAN 20. All right, I'm going to put the IP address for that one, IP address, 192.168.20.254. Oops, I forgot the subnet mask. 255, 255, 255, too excited. All right, do WR, throw shift. All right, show IP route. Let's take a look at that. And you see you're connected to 1020 already. I haven't done nothing with the router, have I? I haven't done anything with the router. Router's off. Right, there's nothing going on. But can this guy ping this guy? I don't know. Let's find out. Ping 192.168. Forget the one. 168. Okay, can't type today. 10.254, not 254, 10.1. And looky here, we're pinging. We have, no, wait a minute. That's my own network. What am I so excited about? All right, 20.1. There we go. Now, let's see. There we go, we're pinging. Get excited again. Woohoo! All right, we didn't need the router. Because a layer 3 device is what we have here. So the router is not even in play. Okay, it's going back and forth. It's just routing it back and forth. They're directly connected like they would be to a router. Okay, and now I'm just back and forth. No need. Their own VLANs, you saw it. They're in their own VLANs, but they're different networks. But since it's a layer 3 device, it creates a routing table. I enabled IP routing, that connectivity. But what happens if I want to go outside? I'm going to go ahead and do a gig 02 here. I'm going to go to that port, that particular port right there. Not really. I'm going to go into Inch VLAN 1. Config T. Inch VLAN 1. IP address 192.168.1.1. 255.255.0. And just no shut that one. All right, do WR. Cool beans. And then we're gonna go to the router and say no here. Is that an M or an N? All right, enable, config T, host name, R1 again, okay? So interface F0/0. All right, I don't need to create sub interfaces. IP address. 192.168.1.2, 255.255.255.0. No shut. All right. Awesome. Who are we connected to? Show IP route. Can I ping the guy? 192.168.1.1. Let's see if I can ping him. I cannot ping him. That is amazing. Okay. Oh, it was still Amber. Too fast, too furious. Where's the, there you go, green now. Let's try it again. It was still Amber. It was going too fast for the computer. Let's hope that's the problem. Yep, too fast. What can I say? It's Laz, it's me. But can't get nowhere else, because if I do a show IP route, I don't know about anything else. So, with that said, let's see if this works. Remember, we haven't trunked that port, the G02. We have not trunked it. If you look at show int trunk, there's no trunk ports, okay? Config T, router rip version 2, network 192.168.1.0, network 192.168.10.0, up arrow 20.0, and then no auto summary, DWR, okay? And then we go to the router. And we do the same thing, config T. But one of the numbers he knows about, router rip, version 2, network, 192.168.1.0, no auto summary, WR. Is he learning about it now? Show IP route, let's see. Show IP route, look at that. Can we ping it? Can we ping one of these? 192.168.20.1, we can ping it. Can I ping? Let's see. Where? Can I ping the router? That's the issue. 192.168.1.1. No, 2. And I can ping the router. So I can ping the router. So what are the differences, ladies and gentlemen? I did not trunk this part at all. I didn't trunk it. I have no trunk ports here. Okay? I'm using routing in order for it to learn the networks that are available in their particular topology. So that, it's the difference between layer 2 and layer 3. Layer 3 makes things more efficient. Layer 2 is still going to be on your test, whatever, learn how to do it this way. But just so you know, that is the difference between using a layer 2 for inter-VLANs and a layer 3 for Inter-Vlans. Hope you liked it.